sponsored by Taco Bell.
Hello, I am Dan Sabret. I am a music performance major at Ithaca College in my last year. I'm a percussionist and a pianist and an amateur singer. I play music all day. I'm probably here on average until like 8, 9, or 10 p.m. most days, just practicing or going to rehearsals, practice for rehearsals, and play in recitals or concerts. Every music performance major is required to give a junior recital and a senior recital. I will be playing just basically a whole bunch of solo marimba pieces and a couple of marimba duets. There's a piece that I wrote on there. It's really stressful, but it's part of the degree. The first piece I ever wrote was senior year of high school. Like, ever since then, like, it was just so satisfying to like write music that came out of my own head and play it like to completion. Definitely inspired by my professor, Gordon Stout, who is known as one of the most prolific marimba composers in the scene. He's really guided me through my compositional life and shaped me into the composer I am, really. When I first got into music, yes, I was but a wee little lad. I was 4 years old. I can remember like sitting in my living room and listening to my sister play piano, and I was like, Mom, I want to learn how to play piano. So she signed me up with the same teacher, and for a while there, I was literally just a pianist. That's all I would ever do, until one day I was at this like birthday party. I'll never forget this birthday party for Talia Creswell, and she had a drum set there that her mom bought her, and I sat behind it. And to be the usual clown of the party that I usually am, I decided to start playing the intro to the Hannah Montana theme song and had like people singing along with me. And then like, I just like started going into it, like really getting into it. Probably a bit too much for Hannah Montana. And I was like, man, this is so much fun. I'm just like exerting all this energy that I have built up because I'm a middle schooler, and like applying it to some things. So that got me into like drum set. And now at this point, I was finishing up my freshman year of high school, and my brother was a senior, but he was a senior at an arts high school that was called Lehigh Valley Performing Arts High School. And I was like, man, that place is so hip. Like, I went there to check it out, and I was like standing in the hallway with this like jam going on. And I was like, wow, this place has a couple of cats. So I auditioned on drum set, got in, thank God. And I was like mostly a pianist that happened to play percussion until the marimba came into my life. And I was like, oh my gosh, it's the best of both worlds. It's the piano, just wooden, and I hit it. This is like both sides of my musical brain just like crashing together into this beautiful instrument. And then over the course of my years there, I ended up being more of a percussionist than a pianist. The learning environment of Ithaca College is very friendly. One of the main things that drew me to this school was how close the percussion studio was here. And it's not until like you actually get here that you realize that's like really legit, and that's probably one of the most important parts of like being here. That everyone is super tight, and everyone's just trying to like spread good vibes and help everyone along the way. Like, no one wants to be like, oh, like I'm so much better than this person, I'm so much better than this person, where you can find that at a lot of other music schools. This place is just sort of like, you scratch my back, I'll scratch yours. I don't know. This place is just really cool. It's really cool. My involvement with other recitals is extensive. You know, being here in the school and doing what I've done to help myself sort of gave me a whole bunch of connections to the other people that are in the school. Whenever someone has a recital that they have to put on, say they need a percussionist to play on something, you know, they'll like shoot me an email or like Facebook message or like stop me in the halls or something and ask me if I'm free to do it. And most of the time I'll say yes. The idea of like I scratch your back, you scratch mine is beneficial for like both parties in the sense that you should never be saying no to opportunities. A great quote that I heard was that success is where skill and opportunity meet. So if you don't have these like opportunities presented by like friends who have played with you before, then you'll never get anywhere, no matter how skillful you are. I think everyone strives to play in as much stuff as they can here, and I know I am playing in a lot of recitals right now, and it's a little bit stressful with my own recital coming up. It's just part of the preparation, and honestly, at the end of the day, it's a lot of fun because playing with your friends is just so much fun. Outside of this building, what do? I play in a band called Butter. Check us out on all streaming platforms. Our EP is For Your Toast. Shameless plug. yeah, we have rehearsal every week, and we play funk music, write our own tunes, we do a bunch of covers, and we gig around to a bunch of venues around the area. I do other gigs as well. I really don't do anything that's like not musical. It's kind of sad, but it never stops. The grind never stops, but it's always fun. It's always fun. So also, I'm in a scuba diving class on the track to be scuba certified internationally for life. So a fun story with my scuba diving class is that a little while back, I decided it would be funny to buy on Amazon a banana hammock, or a mankini as it's advertised on Amazon. So I got that, and it's just so funny. I'd show it to all my friends and they'd like just die laughing. So at one point, just me being myself, I have no shame. And I go into the locker room and I put on my mankini, walk back out to the room, and everyone's like, what is this cat's vibe? I am now like infamously the mankini kid in my scuba diving class. And everyone expects it every week, and honestly, it's a lot of pressure. What is in store for future Dan? Well, music. More music. My name is Dan, and you're watching the Disney Channel. Yeah.